Hello, this third playlist is about how to use task away to run two asynchronous tasks in sequencing. That is, the second task only will run after the first is finished. We used this this example program to demonstrate how we can run two simulate tasks, here two tasks in sequences. That is, the second task only should be executed when the first task is finished. This button is used to launch our code with the demonstration. The code is very simple. You can see here that first the interface is updated. Then we have here the execution of the asynchronous procedure. This is the simulator, this is the long-term execution for with a delay of 10 seconds. And the intrusion away that's made us this the control don't go to the other part of the method unless this method is finished. Then it's updated the interface when this method is finished. Here again, the way I see the way instruction avoid that the control continues to here, and this is second method is executed after this one. Let's see working the application. Put here for more easy to see in this example, and here we go. Let's launch this method. The interface continues to be, and as we see here that the task one is running, but the second not. This is for 10 seconds. Now, with this is finished, continues the second task. Interface continues to be responsive, as you see. And the second task is finished, and this part of the method is executed. Let's see now in detail our example. After the button is clicked, the following procedure is run. The method executes the four first instructions and finds the away with the call to the asynchronous procedure. In this moment, a task is created to be executed asynchronously, and the program control is returned to the main thread and end of the actual method. After the task is finished, the control is returned to the following line after the away line and run to the next away. Here again is created another thread by creating a task, and the control is again returned to the main thread. Only after the second task is finished, the control is returned to the last two lines of the method, and you see the two tasks are executed one after the other. That is all for now. In the next pills, we will demonstrate how to return values for an asynchronous task. And see you in the next pills. Thank you.